Coming up on today's show, Tesla confirms production Model 3 reveal will take place in July, with Tesla truck reveal pinned for September. Chevrolet offers a headline-grabbing $320 lease deal in the US for the Chevrolet Bolt EV. And the Lucid Air hits an impressive 217 miles per hour, 350 kph, during alpha prototype testing. These stories and more coming next on 10. Like all our content, today's show is funded by the in-stream ads on today's video and by the kind donations of viewers like you. Follow the link at the end of today's video to make a monthly donation to our Patreon crowdfunding campaign to help keep us independent and impartial. And if you're already donating, thanks for your continued support. It's Friday, April 14th, 2017. I'm Mika Gordon-Bloomfield, and this is T.E.N., the weekly news roundup show whose job it is to bring you the latest news in cleaner, greener, safer, and smarter transportation without too much hype or hyperbole. Today, we're starting with the confirmation from Tesla CEO Elon Musk that Tesla will reveal the official production version of the Model 3 electric car at a special event in July this year, most likely at a special event where the first customers, most likely Tesla employees, will also get their cars. In keeping with Musk's usual habit of announcing things on Twitter, this particular confirmation was no different, ending speculation that had suggested Tesla was looking for an earlier, June-based reveal date for the production Model 3. At the big July event, we'll not only get to see what production Model 3 models will look like, though spy shots have given us a pretty good idea, but we'll also get to hear about final specifications, pricing, and planned rollout dates for non-US markets. At the same time as confirming the Model 3 production reveal schedule, Musk also confirmed that Tesla's engineers have been working very hard on its planned Tesla Semi, an all-electric tractor unit designed to revolutionize the haulage industry. And while we won't see that at the July event, Musk suggested we'll get to see that for the first time this September. So if you're a Tesla fan, it looks like there's a lot to look forward to in the next few months. While Tesla appears to be going from strength to strength, however, things aren't so good at Ford, which has confirmed this week that it's going to be withdrawing the Ford Focus electric car from sale in Europe, citing lack of consumer interest. The Focus EV, which is about to get a range boost for the markets where it will continue to be sold, is something of a compliance car, built on the same chassis as the internal combustion engine Focus, but with an electric drivetrain instead. But while Ford cites consumer apathy, I think it's fair to lay some of the blame, if not all, at Ford's feet. Aside from the poor design, most of the usual hatchback load bay space was taken up with a battery pack, Ford's done very little to promote the Focus Electric. Even in the US, where Ford needs to sell a certain number of electrics to meet California ZEV mandate laws, Ford has always treated the Focus EV like the bastard stepchild. And I guess that action is coming home to roost at last. As you'll know if you watched last week, a recent study into autonomous vehicle technology concluded that Ford, General Motors, and Renault-Nissan were currently leading the push towards autonomous vehicles, not based on the technology in the marketplace, because that accolade goes fairly and squarely to Tesla, but in terms of technology heading to market soon. Many of you disagreed with that report, but this week at the New York Auto Show, GM's luxury arm Cadillac unveiled Supercruise, a semi-autonomous driving technology debuting on the new CT6 luxury sedan that not only allows for hands-free driving on the highway, but leverages a driver monitoring system designed to ensure the driver remains alert and ready to take over at all times. This, says GM, is an industry first and makes sure that drivers can't abuse the technology by losing all concentration on the road ahead. In this way, then, the system might be doing the driving for you, but you'll still expect it to be a backup for the car. And if you're not alert and doing that, the system will bug you until you are. Given that some people have already demonstrated how easy it is and dangerous it is to abuse autonomous driving technology, and frankly, it is dangerous until we have fully autonomous level 5 vehicles, GM's solution is a very smart addition indeed, and I, for one, can't wait to try it out. Earlier this year, the Tesla Model S P100D became the longest-range electric car you could buy, managing an official 315-mile EPA rating at launch. But being a performance-oriented model, it was only a matter of time before the P100D's range was surpassed by the more frugal Tesla Model S 100D. And this week, that's exactly what happened, with a lower-performance, longer-legged Model S100D getting an official 335-mile rating from the EPA, making it the longest-range electric car on sale anywhere in the world today. Interestingly, it's not quite the most efficient, with the extra weight of the 100 kilowatt hour pack giving it a combined 102 mpge. But still, it's very impressive when you consider that we're talking about a full-size luxury car. So well done, Tesla, and here's to your Model S 110D, because I know you're going to be making one sometime soon. While Hyundai and its sister company Kia have now confirmed their intention to shift away their focus from hydrogen fuel cell technology and more towards battery electric vehicles, it still seems that we're going to see the odd hydrogen fuel cell vehicle here and there among both brands' lineups. At least, that's the conclusion I've come to after Genesys, Hyundai's luxury arm, unveiled the GV80 FCV Concept SUV at the New York Auto Show this week. Looking a lot like the concept fuel cell car Hyundai showed earlier this year, the GV80 Concept is a full-size hydrogen fuel cell SUV that I'd love to tell you more about, but I can't, because it's a concept car. And as other reviewers have noted, the GV80 isn't a car that Hyundai or Genesys seems all that keen to bring to production. Will it? Well, that depends, but given the news from recent weeks about a push towards EVs, I suspect a hydrogen fuel cell model is less likely than a similarly styled EV. Watch this space. It's been available in its launch markets of Oregon and California now for the past 4 months, but while it's been selling steadily, the Chevrolet Bolt EV hasn't exactly been setting any sales records. The reasons? Well, there are a few. Limited availability, a lack of public charging stations, and of course, the competition from the upcoming Tesla Model 3 and 2018 Nissan Leaf. But that might change soon thanks to a new nationwide lease sale announced this week by GM, which has a headline price of $329 US a month for a 3-year, 1,500-mile-per-year lease with $3,809 due at signing. Depending on where you live, the amount at signing could be less, but with the Bolt EV not due to be available nationwide until August, you may have to wait to take this lease deal up, or miss it entirely if GM decides to expire the deal before the car becomes available where you live. While the Bolt EV may have mediocre sales right now, a car we think is certain of even worse sales are the battery electric and plug-in hybrid versions of the Honda Clarity, both of which launched this week officially at the New York Auto Show. With just 18 miles of all-electric range and a CCS quick charging port, the Clarity Electric is most likely going to be a limited market compliance car with an established price tag of $35,000 before incentives. Or in other words, a Tesla Model 3 money for about a third of the range. It will go on sale in California and Oregon later this year, while its sibling, the plug-in hybrid, with 42 miles of electric range, will go on sale in a few more markets. It will have a total range of just 330 miles, which is much less than either the Volt or the Prius Prime, making it yet another car we can't see selling many of. Never mind, Honda, you tried. You shouldn't have cancelled the Fit EV, really. Oh well, too late. If you think I'm obviously disappointed with the upcoming Clarity, then I'm going to tell you now that I'm really impressed with the next car I'm going to talk about, the Lucid Air Luxury EV, a car which has even yet to enter production. You see, this week, as part of its ramp up to a predicted 2018 production launch, Lucid has been putting alpha prototypes for the Lucid Air through a series of engineering tests to see just how good it really is. And that includes high-speed testing. How high a speed? Well, as Lucid announced this week, a prototype Air recently hit 217 miles per hour. That's nearly 350 kilometers per hour during some of its high-speed testing. That's well beyond the top speed of a stock Tesla Model S. And assuming it keeps that speed into production, is going to make some pretty big waves in the plug-in marketplace in the process. While Lucid hasn't confirmed for sure these kind of high speeds will make it into a production model, it has hinted that at least one of its key markets is one in which high speeds in the ballpark of those achieved are expected of premium cars that go on sale. So, Germany then. Talking of Germany, that's where we're heading next, because that's where Tesla's recently acquired Advanced Automation Division is based. And if you're unsure of what that is, it's the name given to the company formerly known as Grohmann Engineering when Tesla acquired it late last year. Specialists in the large construction robots that are found on pretty much every automotive production line, the acquisition of Grohmann Engineering meant that Tesla had its own in-house specialist it could use to build assembly machinery for automotive, battery, and solar panel production lines. At the time of the acquisition, Tesla said that it would let the company keep all of its existing supply contracts, many of which were with the largest automakers in the world. But last week, Tesla has pretty much torn up all of those contracts, focusing instead on the equipment it needs for its own factory, specifically Model 3. It's a move that makes sense, but severs all of the connections with the previous automaker clients that the firm had had. And what's more, it's upset a lot of the workforce who are understandably nervous about Tesla putting all of the factory's eggs in one basket. It's not clear what will happen next, so this is a story we're going to have to update you on as and when we have something else to share. Ever since the Dieselgate debacle, we've seen the concerted effort from Volkswagen to cast itself as a more environmentally conscious, reformed automaker. And part of that has been the almost continual stream of new plug-in models and concept cars we've seen Volkswagen showcase at auto shows to prove the point. Well, next week in Shanghai, Volkswagen will showcase another car that it says will preview an all-electric SUV, supposedly part of the same ID family that brought us the ID and ID Buzz concepts. This new Volkswagen SUV coupe, Volkswagen's words, not mine, envisages a day when Volkswagen produces cars which all have 300 plus miles of all-electric range and can still operate in full level 5 autonomy, entertaining their occupants with an always-on, always-connected, high-speed internet connection. Yep, it's nice, Volkswagen, that you want to make these cars a reality, but come on! Get on with it already. Earlier on in today's show, I touched on the story that I covered last week in which GM, Ford, and Renault, Nissan were placed at higher than Tesla Motors when it came to the industry analysis of how automakers plan to roll out fully autonomous vehicles. And as I mentioned earlier in the show, many of you scoffed at that story, saying Tesla was clearly putting all the effort in where others weren't. But this week, we heard the news that General Motors, specifically its recently acquired Cruise Automation division, is undergoing something of a hiring spree right now, with more than 1,100 new positions advertised at the Cruise Automation headquarters in Silicon Valley. Add to that this week the news that GM has launched a new competition designed to get university students involved in and developing and building autonomous vehicle systems by donating several Bolt EVs to different colleges and universities across the country, and it's clear that GM is most certainly serious about autonomous drive vehicles. The question? How will they fare against Tesla? I'll leave you all to argue about that one in the comments below. Our penultimate story takes us to California, one of the most friendly, welcoming states in the US when it comes to electric vehicles and electric vehicle mass adoption. But this week, a new piece of legislature was passed there, which, come 2020 model year cars, will charge citizens a $100 one-time registration fee upfront for driving their cars, plus an additional annual registration fee ranging from $25 to $175 based on the value of their electric car itself. It's all designed to try and help recoup some of the money the state has lost in recent years from gasoline taxes. As cars become ever more efficient and more people switch to plug-in cars, funding from gasoline taxes, which have traditionally helped pay towards road maintenance, have gotten smaller and smaller. And this new registration program should even out the playing field again. But while most EV owners are more than happy to pay their way, some EV advocates are unhappy about the fee, saying it's too soon and could serve as a disincentive for those considering a plug-in car. But considering California has some of the best EV incentives in the country, however, I'm personally doubtful it'll have a massive negative impact. And finally, it's been in the planning for some time now, could be a serious contender to Formula E in terms of fan base and excitement, and uses race-prepared, stripped-down Tesla Model S P100Ds that can sprint from 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 2 seconds. And now, Electric GT, the first GT race series for electric cars, has confirmed the first two electric Grand Prix of its inaugural season will take place in France at the Paul Ricard circuit on November 25th and November 26th this year. Promoted as a weekend-long festival celebrating technology, sustainability, and innovation, the first two races will be exciting for everyone involved, and I'm keeping my fingers crossed that I'll get to experience at least one of those races firsthand. If I save up my pennies, that is. And on that note, I think it's time for me to say goodbye. As always, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Visit transportevolve.com for more cleaner, greener, safer, and smarter transportation news, or join in the conversation on Twitter at transportevolved. And if you liked what you saw today and you want to help us make more shows like this, please consider making a donation to our Patreon crowdfunding campaign, a link for which is in the description below and a clickable one at the end of today's video. Thanks again for watching. I'll see you next week. I'm Nikki Gordon Bloomfield. That was T.E.N. Have a great weekend. And until next time, keep evolving. We'll be right back.